I want to tell you a little story, something that happened to me a while back. I was meeting a friend for a coffee in the town where I live, and I was just waiting for them in the street. And I noticed down the road a woman was having an argument with someone. And then she turned away from that person and started walking up the road angrily in my direction. And she was kind of stomping up the road, caught up in her world of anger. And because she was kind of caught up in that way and not aware of other people, she walked past a woman with her child, and she brushed up against the child a bit roughly. And the mother looked round and I suppose was feeling protective of her child. And, well, she was caught up in her world. She wasn't able to see that this woman was just distressed and hadn't meant to brush up against her child. And she just snapped back and she just said something like, well, what did you do that for? And then the first woman, because she was caught up in this negative state, instead of just apologising and saying that it was an accident, she squared up to the mother of the child and started altercating with her and swearing with her, swearing at her and so on. And then a man who was passing by sort of saw what was going on and walked up to the woman and took the mother's side and started arguing as well. And they were all sort of squaring up to each other, and a rather ugly little situation was starting to emerge. And this was all happening just a few yards away from where I was standing. And I realised I was probably going to have to get involved and that I needed to intervene and try and help the situation. But I didn't know what to do, and I started feeling resistance, and I started feeling tongue-tied and unsure what the best thing to do was. But anyway, I started kind of moving over towards them, thinking, what am I going to say? But just as I did that, a young woman who was walking up the road, just quite naturally, just as she was walking, linked arms with the first woman, looked her right into the face and just said, come on, love, you don't want to get involved in all that, and just walked her away off down the street and round the corner. And in a way, it was a magical little moment, just the way she looked her in the face and kind of spoke to her kindly, softened her and allowed her to let go of the situation enough to be walked away and out of the kind of confrontational situation. And suddenly an ugly situation was diffused and dissolved and changed and transformed. And I was just left there standing, feeling really inspired, actually. Just the natural and spontaneous way that young woman knew what to do. Yeah. She didn't just know what to do. She had the heart, she had the emotional resources to do it and just immediately respond in that kind of way. And I actually found it quite inspiring, and I thought, well, yes, that's what I want to be like. I want to be the kind of person who's able to respond to different situations quite naturally and spontaneously and who'll know what to do. So in Buddhism, there's this meditation practice called the metta bhavana, the cultivation of loving kindness. And in a way, this practice, this meditation practice, is all about that. It's all about thinking of different people, trying to cultivate friendliness and well-wishing towards them, being aware of them, trying to understand them. So in a way that when we go about our lives, we can respond to the world in that way. We can respond to more and more people in that way. We just know what to do, and we've got the heart, the good heart, to do it, as it were. So in the urban retreat, we're going to be exploring this practice of the metta bhavana. We're going to be looking at it in quite a lot of depth and detail. Each day there's going to be some teaching content. There's going to be a led meditation. There's going to be other talks and resources that you can engage with. And the idea is that you engage with this material as you're living your daily life. So as you're going about your normal week, you'll be able to join in with these meditations, listen to talks, get ideas and suggestions for how to practice as you go about your life. And it's all about, yeah, responding to the world, knowing what to do, having the heart, the good heart, to be able to respond to the world, to be able to respond to more situations with that spontaneous loving kindness. So I hope you'll join us. And I hope that we'll have a really inspiring week together practicing the metta bhavana, the loving kindness meditation.